Hey everybody, and welcome back to my Fallout 3 BB gun run. Today we're going to be heading into Rivet City to work on the Wasteland Survival Guide quest some more. So yeah, we're just going to run up the bridge here and talk to the security officer.
Welcome to Rivet City. Please wait while the bridge extends.
I refuse! Ah! Ow. Okay, so, head back up there. Alright, so yeah, we're just gonna run across the bridge here, which swings around, and talk to, I can't remember this guy's name off the top of my head. Harkness.
State your business in Rivet City.
I'm here to do research on the city's history.
Research, huh? I can't help you there, but you're free to ask around inside. Just don't start any trouble.
Do you know about Rivet City's history?
I don't exactly have time to worry about the history around here, now do I? I've got to worry about what's happening on it now.
Thanks for the help.
Carry on, then.
So, some of you will be expecting me to run right to the science lab and pick up the bobblehead. There's actually a very good reason I'm not going to do that. At level 30, I'm planning on taking the perk that gives me, raises all my stats to 9. After that, you don't get any perks, so you can't use intensive training to raise your stats anymore, but you still can pick up bobbleheads. And it'll actually raise all your stats to 10, so I'm just gonna wait. So here's a Flak and Shrapnel's weapon store. It's actually another good place to get BBs. So we're going to ask Flak if he has any BBs.
This here is Flak and Shrapnel's gun shop. Pretty catchy, huh? Take a look around. If you see anything you like, I'll be right over here.
Can I see what kind of guns you have for sale?
Need to do some killing, eh?
Not particularly, Flak. I'm just hoping you have... weapons, combat armor, stim packs. He doesn't have any BBs, but sometimes he can. I gotta run.
If you need more ammo, this is where to get it.
Thanks, Flak. We're also gonna check the drug vendor, because who doesn't love drugs?
Well, this is a quick fix. I mean, that's the name of our shop. Polly and mine, that is. My name is Cindy. Cindy Cantelli.
What do you have for sale?
We've got all kinds of chems.
Psycho. Yes, that's what we want. So we're going to buy all her doses of Psycho. See if I have anything to sell. I still have energy cells. Sell those. Yeah.
Thanks.
Time for me to leave.
I'm sure you'll be back soon.
So we'll ask her about the history. I forgot
nice
to do
to
that.
Nice to see you again.
What can you tell me about Rivet City's history?
Well, I don't really know, to tell the truth. How does any city get started, really? But I've heard Bannon talk about how he was responsible for its success. So I'd ask him about it.
Okay.
I'm sure you'll be back soon.
Yeah, Bell's going to have to... Bannon?
Welcome to Potomac Attire. I am Bannon, proprietor and city council member. I carry discriminating attire for discriminating customers.
I see you're also a person of refinement.
Between you and me, keeping out the riffraff is good for business.
Could I ask you about Rivet City's history?
Why, I practically set this whole place up. When I got here 12 years ago, it was just a handful of dead enders squatting in a rusted-out rowboat. Now I'm on the council, and with my leadership, we're the strongest settlement in the wastes. Of course, a few of those dead enders still stick around, but who'd want to leave?
Hasn't Rivet City been around for longer than 12 years?
Well, yes, but it was hardly any place of importance until I arrived on the scene. That's all ancient history now. No one would ever care about it. If you insist on wasting your time on that, you could try that bartending old crone down below, Belle Bonnie.
Alright, thanks, dude. Weirdo.
Come back soon.
So we're gonna head, downstairs and talk to Belle Bonnie, if I can remember how to get there. This way?
Everything looks okay here.
Not the Weatherly Hotel.
Nice to see you. I'll be right with you.
Not the flight deck. Okay, I guess we'll head down through that other door. Let's see if actually having the quest activated will let me talk to some people. St. Monica's Church. Nope, we don't want to go that way. Oh, pork and beans. Steal some food out of this horrible looking place. Science labs. Don't need to go there yet. Common room. Marketplace. Okay, we'll just head back to the marketplace. I'm trying to get to the Muddy Rudder. I just can't remember exactly how to get there. There we go. Muddy Rudder. Down.
Whiskey and water. Don't light on the water.
Good to see you.
Hey, lady.
I'm Belle Bonnie. And this is the Muddy Rudder.
You're crouched
weird.
I'll tell
you what I tell all the fresh meat. Don't start anything down here, or I'll have Brock kick your ass.
Nice place you have here.
You must be drunk. Are you gonna order or what?
Have any stories about this place's history?
History? What, not enough shit around here already? You need to dig up more? Don't know if it ever had an official start. It's just been here forever. Stuck in the river and full of assholes.
I bet someone like you hears a lot of stories. Can't you share one?
No, but I can damn sure share a bag of get the hell out of my bar. First one's on the hop.
Really? Because Bannon said he organized the entire place himself.
Huh. Why, that lying son of a bitch. He wasn't even born when I got here. Want to know this tub's history? Only person who really knows it is Pinkerton. And most think he's dead or gone. He's holed up in the other half of the ship. And he don't like visitors. He'll set you straight.
Any good stories lately?
Go talk to Vera if you want gossip. I don't talk bad about folks.
Okay, I'll have a drink.
What'll you have?
See, nope, she just had alcohol, which I do not care about.
I'll be right here when you get thirsty.
I was hoping she might have some drugs. Hey, Ted.
Ted Strayer. You can chill with me if you want, dude.
Thanks. Sounds like a plan, man.
All right, you and me just hanging. Dude, I only just got here myself. Ain't nothing I can tell you.
See you later, Ted.
Later, dude.
Ted's a nice guy. I like him. Oh, and there's blood on the entrance to the bar. All right, so having found out that Pinkerton lives in the other half of the boat, we're going to head back up to Marketplace. We're actually... Council is debating putting railings on the flight deck. So, we want to get over there. So we're going to run back down here. Not jump off the bridge and hurt ourselves this time. Here's Carlos. Hi, Carlos. You can give Carlos purified water for karma, just like you can at Tenpenny Towers or Megaton. Obviously, I don't want my karma to go up because I'm trying to keep it as neutral as possible. Yeah, we're going to head over to that door over there. Man in Hula Hoop. Famous sculpture, of course. Probably going to have to see a doctor pretty soon about getting rid of some of these rads, but unlike Fallout 4, like I said last time, rads aren't that big of a deal in this game. Until you get to 200 rads, you don't even take any penalties, so not too much to worry about. So yeah, head over to Pinkerton's door. And yes, this is locked very hard, and you cannot get through there. So, we have two options. One is to raise our lockpicking skill to 100, which would take quite a while. Or, you head around to the broken side of this ship, where it's broken in between the two sections here. There's actually another door. Down here. Now, you want to make sure you get a good run at it, because you will drown in this game if you take too much time. Something I tend to forget. Go ahead up here. Get a breath. And I don't think there's anything good in this area for loot, so we're just gonna head over to Pinkerton's area. One thing we have to be careful of is there are Mirelurks in this area, so yeah, we're gonna probably have to fight some of those. Hi, there's one right there. Yeah, that's scary. I really don't want to fight him. Get away from me, Mirelurks. So Mirelurks, you want to shoot him in the face. That's where you do the most amount of damage. But don't particularly have a great shot. Still going to take it. We're wearing a radiation suit. We're going to get out of that real quick. Yeah, we're going to take some rads, but we have some rad away. Also pop some drugs. It would actually be a really good idea right now. I should have come in here with a stealth boy. And if I die, that's probably what I'm going to do next time. Because pop some rad away. Pop a couple stim packs. I don't think we hit it. Ugh. I'm just firing wildly because I'm trying to dodge and hit these guys at the same time. Oh, I got hit there. Because I can't go back the way I came from. It'll put me underwater and you can't pull out your guns underwater. I can run over this way though. Yeah, that's good. Let's see. There. Got a decent shot of his face. I think we hit him. Yeah. Couple critical strikes. Do-si-do these guys some more. See, this is why I didn't want to fight dozens of Mirelurks in the Anchorage War Memorial. Oh, they hurt when they hit you. Gonna have to eat some stim packs. Probably take some medics. Help get my damage resistance up. Oh, he's jiggling. Nope, I got stuck. Another critical strike. And we're going to wait for him to get real close, and then we're going to put a couple... Nope. We'll try a couple shots into his face in vats. I think we hit him, because his health went down quite a bit. Taking more rads. Not a problem. We'll get rid of those later. Luckily, these guys aren't too fast, otherwise we'd be in much more trouble. And there's lots of stuff to juke around in here, so we don't have to worry about them coming after us too much. I want to hit him in the face. There we go. Crippled face. Awesome. Knocked me up the stairs. Didn't mean for that to happen because I know there's some traps in the area. Wait, did I not die? Haha, that worked perfectly. I don't know what happened there. I think I set off a gas vent, which blew up and killed these guys, and somehow didn't kill me, so that went really well. There you go. Two Meyer lurks dead. We would have killed them eventually, but I will take fortuitous events when they do happen. Just looking around for some loot. I don't spend a lot of time down here. Can't remember it too well. Make sure we loot these Meyer lurks. Walker. Yeah, I don't need a dog bowl. Head over this way. There's another door. Gonna have to catch my breath before I head back down there. I miss the rebreather from Fallout New Vegas that lets you breathe underwater, because that made exploring underwater way better. Bunch of broken stuff. Oh, we've already been in this room, I think. I'm not sure, though. Maybe not. Radiation levels increased, as you can see there. We'll pop a couple right away, get some of that radiation gone. Yeah, that's going to leave us back outside. I don't want to go outside. What's that here? Head upstairs. Yeah, so that's a... Yeah, we went around in a big circle. That wasn't a good idea. Suitcase. Carton of cigarettes, totally worth picking up. It's worth quite a bit. So what else you got? Ball caps. Nothing. Nuka-Cola? Nuka-Cola. We have to get ourselves a refrigerator soon to make some ice-cold Nuka-Cola so we aren't just carrying around all this dead weight. Came way this way before. Went through there. And this should just lead back to... Yeah, this door. So yeah, that's the bottom of the ship explored, basically. So we're going to head upstairs now and be careful because there is traps. Pop a couple more stim packs so we don't have to worry about just exploding and dying. Medax wore off. Alright. Oh. Landmine. Found it. We're selling. And there's the front door that we could have come in if we had lockpick of 100, but we didn't. So, I'm just going to head over this way. There's a trap. Need to repair 22 to deactivate it, but if I put on my utility jumpsuit, I should have enough. Disarm. See a landmine over there. We're going to run over and grab it. More landmines to sell later. Two rigged combat shotguns. Our repair is not high enough to remove those. Which is sad, if you're playing a different run, those are actually a pretty good way to repair any shotgun you have to use those to repair them. Darts. Ah, yes, and here we go. We're still not there yet, but more stuff to look around for. Nuka-Cola, some of my favorite stuff. Grab more Nuka-Cola. books. Switch? Oh, opens the door. Right, yeah, this terminal's rigged to explode. You can, if you see this little thing up here, it means a terminal's rigged to explode. You can disarm the grenade in it if you do it right, but I don't have high enough repair. Hey, Tinkerton, or Pinkerton, where are you? Hi, Pinkerton.
How the hell did you get in here? I suppose you can't be all that bad if you made it this far without dying. This is the part where you tell me what the hell you are doing bothering an old man who obviously wants to be left alone. Get on with it already.
Tell me about this city's history.
What? I have better things to do than yak about those backstabbers up topside. Now get going.
I hear you're the only one who knows the truth about the river city's founding.
Sounds like you've been poking around, all right. I'm surprised any of those reprobates even remember me. Maybe they still laugh about how they edged me out of the council back then. But you can set the record straight.
Yeah, I can. Setting the record straight is exactly my goal.
For that, you have to go all the way back to when remnants of the Naval Research Institute cleared the Meyer Lurks off this wreck, about 40 years ago. We were looking for new lab space, and this bucket of bolts just happened to have a well-preserved science bay on it. Everything else just grew up around that lab once we got it up and running. The science team was led by one H. Pinkerton.
So you used to be in charge? How did you end up here?
That lasted until about 18 years ago, when those ambitious backbiters like Lee and her little team showed up. She came in with her big Purity Project pipe dream, and my whole staff started working with her, those traitors. She even took my seat on the council. By then, I was glad to leave it behind. But hell, if I'm leaving the city I made great.
Do you have any hard evidence of all this?
Of course I do. A good scientist always keeps track of their data. Here. They probably don't even remember, but I kept the records of that first council meeting. Take them, if it'll put them in their place.
Thanks, Horace.
Don't let your guard down.
If I remember right, that's actually a tape we can play. So, oh, no, just notes. Boring notes. So, while we're down here in Pinkerton's lab, there's a couple other things we can do. There's actually some good loot in here, if I remember right. Yes, big book of science that we're going to steal. Totally want that. There's a lot of good other stuff if you want to steal things. Oh, right. And the Dean's electronics that we want to steal. If I remember right, that's pretty much it for good stuff down here. Besides, well, this is all good loot, but we don't need it for anything, so we're going to ignore it. By the way, if you can't get Pinkerton to talk to you, you can come over to this terminal right here. It requires a key, but you can get it off of Pinkerton. And it'll let you read some files and stuff. Bottle cap mine underneath the workbench. Almost every workbench has a bottle cap mine underneath it. They're really good to pick up for selling. Also, I think it's really weird that Pinkerton has that "hey there" line, like the generic friendly hi, when he's such a jerk. But yeah. So we're gonna head on out. Thanks, Pinkerton. Let's read those books real quick. Aid. Big Book of Science raises our science by one. Dean's Electronics raises our repair by one. Good stuff. Close his door again and head on out. Sadly, we can't just run out through the front door. We're going to have to go back through the bow of the ship again. Down here. down this way. I remember how to get out. No, I know. I have no idea. This way? No. All right, you have to go underneath the stairs. Over here. Back this way. This way. Catch your breath up at the top. And then back under. And here we go. Yeah, and so we're just gonna fast travel back to Moira. Well, that went fairly well. Taking out those Mire Lurks with that explosion was a lucky break, so I'm glad that happened. Head up to Moira. Might be too late to talk to her. Yeah, it's too late. We'll have to wait till tomorrow. Suppose while I'm thinking about it, might as well finish the Megaton Bomb quest. Hot walk over to Mr. Sims here and talk to him about it. Let's put on some nice clothes. Maybe we get a better chance of getting some more money off him.
Yeah?
Let's discuss this bomb.
What about it?
Don't you think someone should disarm that thing?
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good?
Sure do.
Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you.
Come on, Sims, give me some more.
That's pretty steep. Fine. Do it and you'll get your money. Don't screw up, though, or we'll all regret it.
See ya, Sims.
Don't blow us up now.
So, there's actually more to this quest if you want to do it. Like, you can walk up to Moriarty's saloon and there's a guy named Mr. Burke that offers you to blow up the bomb for Tenpenny in Tenpenny's Tower. But, I'm just going to finish this the easy way. So we're going to walk up to the bomb. You need explosives 25 or higher to interact with the bomb. Lucky for me, I've been saving this Raider's Blaster Master helmet. Put that on. Still need 25 or higher. Mentats? Yeah. The bomb appears inert, but further examination reveals it is still quite operational and still quite dangerous. With the right gear, it'd be trivial to rig it to explode. To disarm the bomb, however, would take a highly skilled explosives expert attempt to disarm the bomb. You've successfully disarmed the bomb. And we'll go talk back to Lucas Sims, unless he went inside his house. He went inside his house, didn't he? Alright, so we'll finish that quest when in the morning, it looks like. That sound was our medics wearing off. Let's see if we can find Sims after the drugs wears off. There's Sims. Hi, Sims.
I'll be damned. You did it, didn't you? You disarmed that thing.
Yep.
Here's your reward. Hell, why don't you move in? Could use someone like you. Got an empty place here you can use. Here's the key indeed. It ain't much to look at, but talk with Moira. She's got random odds and ends you might be able to spruce the place up with.
Thanks, Lucas.
Later.
So there we go. Quest completed, the Power of the Atom. And that actually pushes us up to level 5. So, like I said last time, we're going to be pushing science up to 40. And our leftover skill points are going to go into small guns. Now with the Science of 40s, we can pick up the Entomologist perk, which gives us plus 50% damage every time we attack something that's an insect, like a rad roach, giant ant, or rad scorpion. Excellent. 50% damage of, let's see, how much is our BB gun doing right now? 3! So we will be doing 4 damage. So if you head up here, Lucas Sims just gave us the key to our very own shack in Megaton. It's not the nicest house. You could get a nicer one. If you do the quest for Mr. Burke and head to Tenpenny's Tower, you get a suite there. The reason I like Megaton better, less loading screens in between my house and getting outside. Tenpenny Tower has like three of them.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Wadsworth, your personal robotic butler. I am here to look after your needs and to keep you happy and entertained. What can I do for you?
I need something to drink.
Certainly, sir. Here you are.
And, I need something to drink.
Certainly, sir. Here you are.
Get some free purified water off him. I think that says
all. Certainly, sir. Here you are.
When do you run out?
Certainly, sir. Here you are. I'm sorry, sir. My condensation collectors need time to fully recharge before I can continue to dispense any more beverages.
Good job, Wadsworth. Tell me a joke.
A neutron walks into a bar. How much for a drink here, anyway? To which the bartender responds, for you, no charge.
The worst jokes.
I'll be sure and tidy up while you're away, sir.
So, the reason I wanted to come in here, a couple reasons. First, when I buy the house, I like to loot everything out of it and then go sell it back to Moira because none of this stuff is useful and just makes the house longer to reload. Got a little door here. Stuff. Desk. While there's a bunch of different stuff in here, places you can store your stuff, you actually really only want to store your stuff in this locker right next to the door, this one right here, because this one won't reset. So even if you're really away from your house for a really long time, this locker won't, you won't lose your stuff. So what are we going to throw in here? We don't need the Raider Blaster Master helmet anymore. Well, we can sell that. Utility jumpsuit. Hang on to all that stuff. Hang on to that stuff. Hey, there we go. We're gonna store our Nuka-Cola Quantums. We're saving those for a quest. Everything else we're looking to sell. Put that office employee ID and our pre-war books in there. Scrap metal we can give to Walter next time we see him. That's about it. It's a fairly low-level loot type of game. Most games I'd have lots of stuff in there, but because we're only using the BB gun, we don't have to really worry about that. Speaking of BB guns, I wonder if we can repair this one with the other one. Maybe if we put on our repair jumpsuit? Nope. Not yet, but we should equip the other one. It has higher damage or higher DPS. That's one thing I do have to remember, that when you switch weapons, you can actually reload a lot faster, which is a good idea sometimes because the BB gun takes a while to reload. Hey, Moira, we're back. Hey, Harden.
Any luck finding out how Rivet City got started?
After a lot of searching, I got the real history of Rivet City.
Aha! Not just as easy as asking around, was it? Good information takes real work to uncover after all. So, tell me all about it.
Some old coot said as he took these notes. They seem reasonable enough.
Well, this data looks legitimate. An outgrowth of a science station, huh? Just goes to show what I always say about cleverness. A bit of smarts leads to a big reward, huh? Speaking of which, in thanks, have a few of these for the next time you've got to be quick on your wits. Oh, and I'll let the Rivet City traders know they'll be favorably mentioned in the book. You'll get a discount buying gear from them in the future.
More research?
I've got to do a section on working with old computer electronics. So there's some research to be done in the old Robco production facility. Also, there used to be a big library out there. Imagine a whole building full of books. I'll need you to gather information there for me. And that'll be it for the last chapter. So, what'll it be?
Library.
Oh, that sure saved me a lot of time. But I bet their book wouldn't have anything about exploding mole rats, would it?
No, it would not.
Books are where the old world kept its knowledge, and libraries are where it kept the books. And there's supposed to be one in Arlington. See if it's still there, and if you can download records from its computer. Information dumps like those would be invaluable for rebuilding humanity.
Okay, I'll check out my local library.
Great. The library should be in Old Arlington, not far from downtown. See if you can download the archives from its computer. If you can't get those, then even the card catalog would be useful. Any little piece of information could help the book, and thus humanity.
You're really, really chipper, Moira. Repair my stuff.
If you've got the caps, I've got the skill.
So, yeah, we're gonna repair both our BB guns and our Talon combat armor.
Sure thing.
See if she's got anything good for sale. Alright, now that we own our own house, we can actually buy things for our house. The first thing we want to buy is a Nuka-Cola machine, which we have enough money for. We're going to sell her some more stuff to try to make some of that money back. Keep that. Sell that Raider Blaster. Sell her some whiskey. See if we have any other more alcohol to sell here. We're gonna keep everything else. So, thanks, Moira.
Good hunting. The info you're bringing back is great.
So, now that we have our own refrigerator, we're gonna head over to, back to my house. You can either go around the back way or up this way. It's actually a little bit easier to go up the back way. I forget that all the time, though, and run up the other way, which is, like, two houses down. So we head into our house, and upstairs we now have a Nuka-Cola machine, which is very good for one specific reason. So, add all Nuka-Colas you're carrying to and make them ice cold. Get some ice cold Nuka-Cola. So if you look, we now have ice cold Nuka-Cola, which heals 24 instead of 12, which is way better. With our skill of medicine, it's all about as good as a med pack right now. So, yeah, that's where we're going to call it for a part next time. Next time, we're going to be starting a different quest. We will continue on with Wasteland Survival Guide in the future, but next time, look forward to something special. Thank you very much for joining me. This has been my Fallout 3 BB Gun